Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I hope you will be fine, happy and healthy. Our dear viewers and listeners, today we will begin the activity, and the number of the activity is presentation 8, level 1, unit 3. And the title of the activity is Asking About Location. What? Asking about location. Asking mean poochna. About location, mahli waqu ke bare mein ya jagah ke bare mein. Location mean jagah ya mahli waqu ke bare mein poochna. Ke ek banda kahan hai. So we will ask about them. First, let's read the presentation, and after that we will inshallah explain it. So you should repeat with me, dear viewers and listener. Is Lisa in the bathroom?
Is Lisa in the bathroom?
Yes, she is.
Yes, she is.
Is Bob in the bedroom?
Is Bob in the bedroom?
No, he isn't.
No, he isn't.
He's in the dining room.
He's in the dining room.
Are the bikes in the yard?
Yes, they are.
Are the cats in the kitchen?
No, they aren't.
They are in the living room. Yeah. So that was the presentation, dear viewers and listener. As you know, that when we are making question form from the positive or affirmative form, so we use the verb or the auxiliary verb in the beginning, and we use the subject after it. For example, here you see Bilal's in the classroom. Where's Bilal? He is in the classroom. So when we want to make question sentence from it, so this contraction form of is jo hai, we will change it into in the beginning of the sentence, because it is question sentence. So is Bilal. We will use is to the place of subject and subject to the place of is. And after that, we will use the same sentence. Is Bilal in the classroom? Classroom. And then we will use sign of interrogation. Mostly the student forget that's a sign of interrogation at the end of question sentence. So try to use the sign of interrogation in the at the end of the question sentence, and in this way we will make the question. In the question sentence, we should also use a little bit the question intonation. Is Bilal in the classroom? Because we are not aware about him, that where Bilal is. So there will be a little bit istifham or question type intonation in the question. Similarly, if we say Saeed and Ahmad's are in the kitchen. Saeed or Ahmad's kitchen mein hai. So that is plural noun. Saeed and Ahmad are plural noun. So before plural noun we use are. So when we want to make the question sentence of it, so we will say are in the beginning. Are Saeed and Ahmad? Are Saeed and Ahmad in the kitchen, in the parlor? Parlor mean better, in the parlor. And then we will use sign of interrogation over here. In the parlor, because question. So yes, they are. For plural, we will say the answer yes. Yes, they are. Yes, they are. And here we will use our strong palm, not to contraction palm of weak palm, but yes, they are. Haan, woh hai. Are. Aur agar nahi hai, so no, they aren't. No, no, they aren't. Are not ka contraction form kya hai? Aren't. Mostly we say aren't. So aren't is wrong pronunciation, not correct pronunciation. Aren't. No, they aren't. And then we say they are in the living room, or they are in, where they are, then we tell the person. Saeed and Ahmad in the parlor? No, they aren't. They are in the lawn. Lawn means chaman mein hai. They are in the kitchen. They are in the dining room. They are in Bilal's shop. They are in the ground. They are. No, they aren't. The contraction form of are not is what, dear viewers and listeners? Aren't. Are not. A contraction form is aren't. you should try to use it aunt. Right, and when the noun is singular, so we will use as in the beginning. And actually, these are yes no question. What type of question?
Yes,
yes no question. There are two type of question. One is called information question. One is called yes no question. Some other types are also there. For example, take question, intonational intonation question, etc. But yes no question are those question the answer of which we can give in the form of yes or no. The answer of which we can give in the form of yes or no, and usually they begin from B auxiliary. B have the B relative are as or am in the present, as or and am in the present. Similarly, was, were in the past, was, were in the past. Sometime yes no question begin with have auxiliary as well. Have auxiliary. Have auxiliary are has or have in the present, have or has in the present, and had in the past. It means the type of question begin with as or am, was, were, have, has, or had. So these are yes no question. Another one, do auxiliary also be, we begin these are also yes no question. And do are do for plural, does for singular, inshallah we will discuss them. And did for past, a date for past. So that is also yes no question. Similarly, modal auxiliary also yes. Modal auxiliary, modal auxiliary are also yes no question. Modal auxiliary are 8 or 9 in number. They are well, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might. Inshallah, we will discuss this later on. Now it will getting confusing. So I mean to say, when a question begin from B auxiliary, have auxiliary, do auxiliary, or modal auxiliary. So the answer of them we can give in the form of yes or no. For example, is Elias a student?
Yes,
yes he is. Is your mother a student?
No,
she isn't. Are we Muslim?
Yes.
Yes, we are. Was Bilal at home yesterday?
Yes.
Yes, he was. Yeah, no, he wasn't. Were you at home yesterday?
No.
Yes, we were. Yeah, no, we weren't. Good. Similarly, have auxiliary we use in the perfect tenses. Have you taken the lunch? आपने दोपहर का खाना खाया है? Yes, we have. या no, we haven't. Has Bilal written a letter? Yes, he has. No, he hasn't. Had you been to Karachi? Yes, I had. No, I hadn't. Similarly, do you recite the Holy Quran?
Yes,
I do. Does Bilal play cricket?
No.
Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Similarly, did you go to Temargara yesterday?
Yes,
I did. Yes, I did. No, I didn't. Similarly, modal auxiliary. Will you take the class tomorrow?
Yes.
Yes, I will. No, I won't. Will not, short form also, inshallah, we will discuss. But won't. Won't is the contraction form of will not. Will not. Willn't is wrong. Sometimes student pronounce willn't. So willn't is wrong. Won't is the contraction form of will not. I won't go there tomorrow. I won't call you. I won't take the class because I don't feel well. So these are the yes no question. Now dear viewers, I will ask you the question and you will answer me either in the form of yes or no. Is Ahmed in the living room?
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. Is Ahmed in the dining room?
No, he isn't.
Gordon, no, he isn't. He is in the living room. Then you will correct me the answer. Is Fatma in the living room?
No, she isn't.
Gordon, no, she isn't. She is in the dining room. So loudly, you should say. Is Khalid in the dining room?
No, he isn't.
Good. No, he isn't. He is at the hospital. Here you will also try to use that we use in before small section of workplace and we use it before workplace. Before what? Workplace. So, no, he isn't. He is at the hospital. Before hospital, we will use it. Is your mother at the hospital?
No, she isn't. She is at the
Gordon. No, she isn't. She is at home. Home is also workplace, so we should use it. Is your mother at home?
Yes, she is.
Yes, she is. Is Najma at home?
No, she isn't. She's in the kitchen.
Good. No, she isn't. She's in the kitchen. Is Najma in the kitchen?
Yes, she is.
Good. Is Sajid in the kitchen?
No, he isn't.
Good. No, he isn't. He's at the university. Now you see, brother, over here, chairs, this is plural. Similarly, students are also plural. And dogs are also plural. So, plural or before plural, we will use what auxiliary verb?
Are.
Inshallah, we will begin the tenses and you will learn it well. But you should keep it in mind that before plural, we should use are. So, are the chairs in the university? At the university?
Good.
No, they aren't. They are in the classroom. We will use they for more than one. We will use they. No, the chairs, the native speaker don't say that are the chairs at the university. So, no, the chair aren't at the university. They don't say the native speaker. The native speaker say no, they aren't, because for more than one chair, we use the pronoun. And we use the pronoun they for non-living thing, for human being or for animal when they are more than one. For example, these are marker and they are black and blue. They are black. For the second time when I am pointing to talking about it, so they are blue and black marker. Understood? Similarly, are the student in the classroom?
No, they aren't.
No, they aren't. They are at school. At school. Similarly, dogs, are the dogs at the school?
No, they aren't.
No, they aren't. They are in the parking lot. Understood? So you see, chairs are non-living thing, students are human being, and dogs are animal. But they are plural, so we will use are before that, and in the answer form, we will use they for all these three. Yeah, now you ask me quickly a question and I will answer. When I point out to when, so you will say the question. Is No, he isn't. He's in the living room.
Is Fatma in the living room?
No, she isn't. She's in the dining room.
Is Fatma in the room?
No, he isn't. He's at hospital.
Is your mother at hospital?
No, she isn't. She's at home. Khalid, for Khalid, we should use he. Sorry. Yeah. Now, next one.
Is Najma in the kitchen?
Yes, she is.
Is Najma
at home?
No, she isn't. She's in the kitchen.
Is Sajid in the university?
Yes, he is.
Is Sajid in the kitchen?
No, he isn't. He's at the university.
Are the chairs in the university?
No, they aren't. They are in the classroom.
Are the chairs in the classroom?
Yes, they are.
Are the students in the university?
No, they aren't. They are at school.
Are the dogs in the parking lot?
Yes, they are. So I hope you will have learned how to make the yes no question from the present auxiliary as and are in this activity. You should try to watch it 5-6 times in order to understand it very well. Thank you so much for watching the video. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I hope you will be fine, happy and healthy. Our dear viewers and listeners, today we will begin the activity, and the number of the activity is presentation 8, level 1, unit 3. And the title of the activity is asking about location. What? Asking about location. Asking mean poochna. About location, mahli waqoo ke bare mein ya jaga ke bare mein. Location mean jaga ya mahli waqoo ke bare mein poochna. Ke ek banda kahan hai. So we will ask about them. First, let's read the presentation, and after that we will inshallah explain it. So you should repeat with me, dear viewers and listener. Is Lisa in the bathroom?
Yes, she is.
Yes,
she
is. Is Bob in the bedroom?
Is Bob in the bedroom?
No, he isn't.
No, he isn't.
He's in the dining room.
He's in the dining room.
Are the bikes in the yard?
Are the bikes in the yard?
Yes, they are.
Yes, they are.
Are the cats in the kitchen?
Are the cats in the kitchen?
No, they aren't.
No, they aren't.
They are in the living room.
They are in the living room.
Yeah, so that was the presentation, dear viewers and listener. As you know, that when we are making question form from the positive or affirmative form, so we use the verb or the auxiliary verb in the beginning and we use the subject after it. For example, here you see Bilal's in the classroom. Where's Bilal? He is in the classroom. So when we want to make question sentence from it, so this contraction form of is jo hai, we will change it into in the beginning of the sentence because it is question sentence. So is Bilal. Is Bilal, and this other we will use is to the place of subject and subject to the place of is. And after that, we will use the same sentence. Is Bilal in the classroom? Classroom. And then we will use sign up interrogation. Mostly the student forget that's a sign up interrogation at the end of question sentence. So try to use the sign up interrogation in the at the end of the question sentence, and in this way we will make the question. In the question sentence, we should also use a little bit the question intonation. Is Bilal in the classroom? Because we are not aware about him, that where Bilal is. So there will be a little bit istifham or question type intonation in the question. Similarly, if we say Saeed and Ahmad's are in the kitchen. Saeed or Ahmad's kitchen mein hai. So that is plural noun. Saeed and Ahmad are plural noun. So before plural noun we use are. So when we want to make the question sentence of it, so we will say are in the beginning. Are Saeed and Ahmad, are Saeed and Ahmad in the kitchen, in the parlor? Parlor mean better, in the parlor. And then we will use sign up interrogation over here. In the parlor, because question. So yes, they are. For plural, we will say the answer yes. Yes, they are. Yes, they are. And here we will use our strong form, not a contraction form of weak form, but yes, they are. Haan, wo ho hai. Are. Aur agar nahi hai, so no, they aren't. No, no, they aren't. Are not का contraction form क्या है? Aren't. Mostly we say aren't. So aren't is wrong pronunciation, not correct pronunciation. Aren't. No, they aren't. And then we say they are in the living room, or they are in where they are. Then we tell the person. Are Saeed and Ahmad in the parlor? No, they aren't. They are in the lawn. Lawn mean chaman mein hai. They are in the kitchen. They are in the dining room. They are in Bilal's shop. They are in the ground. They are. No, they aren't. The contraction form of are not is what, dear viewers and listeners? Aren't. Are not, a contraction form is aren't. You should try to use it aren't. Right? And when the noun is singular, so we will use is in the beginning. And actually these are yes no question. What type of question?
Yes,
yes no question. There are two type of question. One is called information question, one is called yes no question. Some other types are also there. For example, take question, intonational intonation question, etc. But yes no question are those question the answer of which we can give in the form of yes or no. The answer of which we can give in the form of yes or no. And usually they begin from B auxiliary. B have the B relative are as or am in the present, as are and am in the present. Similarly, was, were in the past. Was, were in the past. Sometime yes no question begin with have auxiliary as well. Have auxiliary. Have auxiliary are has or have in the present. Have or has in the present and had in the past. It means the type of question begin with is or am, was, were, have, has or had. So these are yes no question. Another one, do auxiliary also be, we begin these are also yes no question. And do or do for plural, does for singular, inshallah we will discuss them. And did for past, a date for past. So that is also yes no question. Similarly, modal auxiliary also yes. Modal auxiliary, modal auxiliary are also yes no question. Modal auxiliary are 8 or 9 in number. They are will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might. Inshallah, we will discuss this later on. Now it will getting confusing. So I mean to say, when a question begin from be auxiliary, have auxiliary, do auxiliary, or modal auxiliary. So the answer of them we can give in the form of yes or no. For example, is Elias a student?
Yes.
Yes, he is. Is your mother a student?
No,
she isn't. Are we Muslim?
Yes.
Yes, we are. Was Bilal at home yesterday?
Yes.
Yes, he was. Yeah, no, he wasn't. Were you at home yesterday?
No.
Yes, we were. Yeah, no, we weren't. Good. Similarly, have auxiliary we use in the perfect tenses. Have you taken the lunch? आपने दोपहर का खाना खाया है? Yes, we have. या no, we haven't. Has Bilal written a letter? Yes, he has. No, he hasn't. Had you been to Karachi? Yes, I had. No, I hadn't. Similarly, do you recite the Holy Quran?
Yes,
I do. Does Bilal play cricket? Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Similarly, did you go to the Margara yesterday?
Yes,
I did. No, I didn't. Similarly, modal auxiliary. Will you take the class tomorrow?
Yes,
I will. No, I won't. Will not, short form also, inshallah, we will discuss. But won't. Won't is the contraction form of will not. Will not. Willn't is wrong. Sometimes student pronounce willn't. So willn't is wrong. Won't is the contraction form of will not. I won't go there tomorrow. I won't call you. I won't take the class because I don't feel well. So these are the yes no question. Now dear viewers, I will ask you the question and you will answer me either in the form of yes or no. Is Ahmed in the living room?
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. Is Ahmed in the dining room?
No, he isn't.
Gordon, no, he isn't. He is in the living room. Then you will correct me the answer. Is Fatma in the living room?
No, she isn't.
Gordon, no, she isn't. She is in the dining room. So loudly, you should say. Is Khalid in the dining room?
No, he isn't.
He is at the hospital. Here you will also try to use that we use in before small section of workplace and we use it before workplace. Before what? Workplace. So, no, he isn't. He is at the hospital. Before hospital, we will use it. Is your mother at the hospital?
No, she isn't.
She is
at home.
Gordon, no, she isn't. She is at home. Home is also a workplace, so we should use it. Is your mother at home?
Yes, she is.
Yes, she is. Is Najma at home?
No, she isn't. She is in the kitchen.
Gordon, no, she isn't. She is in the kitchen. Is Najma in the kitchen?
Yes, she is.
Good. Is Sajid in the kitchen?
No, he isn't.
He isn't. Good. No, he isn't. He is at the university. Now you see, brother, over here, cheers. This is plural. Similarly, students are also plural and dogs are also plural. So, plural or before plural, we will use what auxiliary verb?
Are.
Inshallah, we will begin the tenses and you will learn it well. But you should keep it in mind that before plural, we should use are. So, are the chairs in the university, at the university?
No, they aren't.
No, they aren't. They are in the classroom. We will use they for more than one. We will use they. No, the chairs, the native speaker don't say that are the chairs at the university. So, no, the chair aren't at the university. They don't say the native speaker. The native speaker say no, they aren't, because for more than one chair, we use the pronoun. And we use the pronoun they for non-living thing, for human being or for animal when they are more than one. For example, these are marker and they are black and blue. They are black. For the second time when I am pointing to talking about it, so they are blue and black marker. Understood? Similarly, are the student in the classroom?
No, they aren't.
No, they aren't. They are at school. At school. Similarly, dogs, are the dogs at the school?
No, they aren't.
They are at in the parking lot. Understood? So you see, chairs are non-living thing, students are human being, and dogs are animal. But they are plural, so we will use are before that, and in the answer form, we will use they for all these three. Yeah, now you ask me quickly a question and I will answer. When I point out to when, so you will say the question. Is No, he isn't. He's in the living room.
Is Fatma in the living room?
No, she isn't. She's in the dining room.
Is Khalid in the room?
No, he isn't. He's at hospital.
Is your mother at hospital?
No, she isn't. She's at home. Khalid, for Khalid, we should use he. Sorry. Yeah. Now, next one.
Is Najma a teacher?
Yes, she is.
Is Najma
at home?
No, she isn't. She's in the kitchen.
Is Sajid in the university?
Yes, he is.
Is Sajid in the kitchen?
No, he isn't. He's at the university.
Are the chairs?
Yeah. No, they aren't. They are in the classroom.
Are the chairs in the classroom?
Yes, they are.
Are the students in the university?
No, they aren't. They are at school.
Are the dogs in the parking lot?
Yes, they are. So I hope you will have learned how to make the yes no question from the present auxiliary as and are in this activity. You should try to watch it 5-6 times in order to understand it very well. Thank you so much for watching the video.